you can post your question here. You see that we have loads of questions every day. From Coma, he was asking about a refractor instead of a Dobsonian. He asked us, what's your opinion in buying Star Travel refractor from Skywatcher? He received very nice recommendations from other people here, but the refractor he was choosing was not apochromatic. It was only achromatic. And I said, and I say to you, I will not buy a refractor with a quality of optics lower than what I have outside. A doublet apochromatic refractor. Lower than that, not for me, because of the aberrations. This refractor I have outside has coma at the edges. I'm using a focal reducer which works with it, so I don't have that coma. But if that focal reducer didn't work, I could live with that. I could cut the edges, as I always do when I use a cheap focal reducer with a Newtonian telescope. Remember when I use a cheap focal reducer, a 50 bucks focal reducer, in my 8-inch for demonstrations purpose, I get a faster optics, very bright objects and easy to capture. However, the edges are all warped. So that's a problem with even a 2-inch focal reducer, a cheap one. And if you use a 1.25, even worse. That's why I don't recommend, if you going to buy a focal reducer for your Newtonian, because you are on a budget, you can't afford a Sterzona Nexus, it's expensive. You buy a cheap focal reducer, 50 bucks. They are all the same. GSO, TS Optics, I don't know, all the brands that you see around 50 bucks are more or less the same. So when I do that, I do the live stack here with you, and some of you may remember, I have to cut or zoom, and then at the end cut the picture. But I can crop and I can live with that, because what I want is the core of the image. It's the object, usually a galaxy or a nebula or whatever, because as someone said here, You zoom a lot with a Dobsonian telescope, with that focal length. So the Dobsonian telescope go deeper, and we don't want to count all the stars as many people do with the refractors. They are very worried about all the stars, and if the star do like this or do like that. We here don't care about that. So we crop and we benefit from a cheap focal reducer to get faster optics. I'm talking about this reducer, or this kind of reducer. It's very cheap, but has that problem. So this telescope, this refractor, has the same problem. You use a refractor and at the edges, as I could see immediately in the first picture I took, I will push the original without cropping. The first picture I took with this refractor was the Horsehead Nebula, then I cropped, because I was not using yet the Sterzona Nexus. I didn't know it will work, and it works. So that original picture was this one, which as you can see it has the effect of the rotation. This is because it's an altazimuth mount, so with an altazimuth mount you will get the rotation effect here. Different that if you are using an equatorial mount. So you get this, and look at the corners, look at this. You see the stars here at the corner? At the edges, look. All the edges like this, look. All the edges like this. However, at the center they are not like this. They are fine. Well, they moved a bit, but this was because of the tracking. Nothing to do with a coma, with the distortions. They are all at the same position. We have odd pixels because I didn't make darks yet, now I have already. So that's why we are not watching odd pixels in our live stream. Yeah, things to have into account. And the image was great. I cropped it and it was, the final image was cropped. So I could have, still have distortions at the edges, but I can live with that. Although, with the refractor he was suggesting in the Discord, the star travel, the problem is you not only have those distortions at the edges, but you have to deal with chromatic aberration, which is very... it's horrible. And I show him in the Discord and I will show you what that means through an image. Look what I did. I posted one picture with a very cheap 50 bucks refractor, now it's 100 bucks. At the left, this is bad optics, bad quality. If you have a refractor, this is the Power Seeker 70AZ. So you can imagine, it's this telescope. So I use this telescope to take this picture. Look at the aberrations, you see? And the colors are awful, everything. And now look at the difference with this telescope that I'm using right now. You see? The stars? Look at this. Look at Alnitak, which is a super bright star that usually blows the images. Look at this. You see? More quality. That to say to you that when I chose this telescope, was thinking in a good solution for a budget refractor telescope for wide field images with the minimum quality required to get decent pictures. And guess what? I won it, because we are getting very nice pictures. Not only this one, but yesterday the one with a Rosette Nebula, the second test with a nebula, and you can see the beauty of it. This was only, the astrophotography here was Topaz Denoise, Topaz AI here. You have the links of this software and all my gear in dobsonianpower.com. Visit that site if you want free resources also. And we have all of this beauty. Look at this. This is what this telescope is for. Large nebula. With my Dob, I can get this. Okay, I can get more detail here. But it's cutted, and there's a disadvantage. As I can't get the contrast, so it's not so pretty, the nebula. The nebula, like a large nebula, is much more beautiful if you can get the contrast of the nebula. This, in this case, the hydrogen over the background, the black background of the stars, of the sky. And then you can see better these fainter details in the outer edges of the nebula, contrasting with this one. So it looks like a rose. It looks like a beautiful rose with a cluster here in the center. Not like a Dobsonian that does this. And the camera dealing with all this hydrogen, the red tint here, although it's natural, will be worst on camera, the final result.